Now, the Kenyan Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission will soon start investigations on members of parliament who may have irregularly claimed mileage and sitting allowances. The probe would also include parliamentary staff and the procurement department, while handing over an audit report on financial management systems at the Parliamentary Service Commission. The EACC CEO Halakhe Waqo said there were loopholes in the system which require urgent fixing. Well, KTN's Patrick Kabimo has been following proceedings at the handover event held at the Nairobi Safari Park and now joins us. Patrick, what more did this particular report reveal?
Thank you, Betty. Indeed, this particular report has had the various issues because it was looking at the management system.
Mm-hmm. Right, Patrick, if you can hear me, tell us more about this particular report.
Thank you so much, Betty. Indeed, this particular report has come up with supposed to be an audit on the financial management system of the Parliamentary Service Commission, where the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission has identified various loopholes into this service commission, especially with regard to the management of mileage and seating allowances. The team noted that there are cases where members of the committee in various house committees sign on behalf of their members who have not attended those particular sittings. Other areas also we have where staff, the Parliamentary Service Commission staff, sign on behalf of their colleagues who have not attended these particular sittings. And this is a loophole that the Anti-Corruption Commission feels Kenyans are losing a lot of losing their cash. There are cases where members of parliament have claimed mileage during recess when the house is on recess, but they keep on claiming mileage as having visited constituencies. They have also identified areas where MPs are out of the country, but strange enough, they claim mileage. So the commission says it will be launching investigations, and those members of parliament will be culpable, then they will be prosecuted or punished for this kind of irregularity. The other area that was noted is that the payroll management system is not adequate, in that we have cases of former members of parliament who are still on payroll. So the commission has advised that the Parliamentary Service Commission should update its payroll so that these former members of parliament who are still on the payroll are removed from the payroll. It was also identified that when it comes to the financial accounts, the finance and accounts department, it was identified that it doesn't have relevant manuals, circulars, and other guidelines necessary for effective management of its financial resources. These now opens opportunities or loopholes for misuse of funds at the commission. So the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission has given the chair of the Parliamentary Service Commission a month to implement the recommendations that are in the report that will ensure that these loopholes are sealed and in so doing protect public money. And especially when it comes to these the lack of financial records, it was the commission notes that there is a the auditor report has always said that parliament is using a lot of money, spending a lot of money on entertainment. And this is because it has noted that parliament does not, parliament staff do not pay for those entertainment allowances, say when it comes to food and those hospitality industries. So they want these kind of hospitality industry arrangements put in the system so that they pay interest for it. Betty?
Right. Patrick, maybe very briefly, when are these investigations set to start?
Today it was the launch of the report because the chairman of the Parliamentary Service Commission did invite the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission to look at the financial systems and give recommendations. But the CEO says now after the report, they've discovered there are loopholes and there are also cases of irregularities which have been identified. Now, the Ethics, the Anti-Corruption Commission will be moving in to investigate those cases, and if they find that crimes have been committed, then responsible staff, if they are for the responsible parliamentary staff, and even members of parliament, if they'll be found to have involved themselves in irregularities, then they stand to be investigated and prosecuted. These we expect it to start a month from now, because the Parliamentary Service Commission has been given a month to implement the recommendations. But as for investigations, the ethics, the Anti-Corruption Commission will come in once they study the reports and identify this particular department, if it's procurement or if it's to do with members of parliament who have been involved in irregularities, then they will move in and start investigations. That one we're looking at a period of maybe 2 months from now.
Right. Thank you very much, Patrick Amimo, there giving us the details of this new way of getting errant members of parliament to be prosecuted after claiming mileage and sitting allowances that actually do not exist and have been irregular. Now,